Time to visit your mother in Illinois.
How do you know all this?
I've been following you for a while now.
Why?
To set forth my plan.
What plan?
You'll see soon enough, but for now I think that you wanted to get yourself out of those restraints. I mean, a big, bad cop like yourself surely can get out of some duct tape. A sister.
Why am I here?
Do you recognize my last name? Conrad?
No, I don't. Can you please just tell me what is going on? I'll do anything. Just let me go, please.
Anything.
Anything.
Pick up the briefcase. That easy?
God, you really are an idiot.
I got my hands on you. I'm gonna cut you limb from limb. And what you bleed to death, you sick piece of shit.
Yeah, and I look forward to it, but for right now, you might want to pick up that phone.
Somebody wants to talk to you.
You really need to start paying attention, Lord Corey. You'll make things much less complicated.
If you hurt my wife or my daughter, I'll spend the rest of my life making sure your every waking moment's a living hell.
Knowing the threats, Corey. All it hurt was all if you followed the rules. Pick up the lighter.
My sister was held captive for 4 days. She was tortured, raped, and beaten for those 4 days. One of her captor's favorite things was to burn her flesh.
You know, he'd hold the flame to her skin until it began to crackle and break open into bloody blisters. Imagine the smell of your own burning flesh. We're gonna play a game. You feel what my sister felt. You feel the burn that she felt. She went 4 days. You go 4 minutes. 4 minutes of pure, unadulterated pain. And each time you don't stop in that 4 minute time span, decreases the time set on the explosive planet in your house.
Whoa, what are you talking about?
Last week, you had a new hot water heater installed. Tell me, who installed that heater?
I don't know, I wasn't at home. I was at work, my wife was there.
Perhaps you shouldn't let dangerous people into your home.
Please. Just don't hurt them.
Well, that's up to you, Corey. You ensure their safety.
I'll kill you!
Empty threats, Corey. Empty threats. Time starts now.
First stop, 3 minutes and 50 seconds to go. Oh, come on, you can do better than this. Such a big, strong man. My sister wasn't even half your size. Very good, Corey. Very good. Your wife and daughter are safe for a little while longer.
I'm sorry about what happened to your sister. I really am. I don't understand why you're doing this to me. Why? What did I do?
You did nothing. My sister was released on the 4th day. She came to your precinct and reported her attack. You turned her away. You didn't even bother to investigate.
Oh, so you do remember her.
She was always being brought in for prostitution and possession of narcotics. She cried wolf so many times.
My sister needed help and you threw her to the street like a piece of fucking garbage.
We thought she was lying. She was always so high. Every other time we went out for one of her calls, it ended up being another one of her drug-induced hallucinations.
My sister was sick. She needed help. It's your job to help those who need it the most.
Then let me make it right. We can catch the guy that did this to her. We can help her.
Too late. She's dead. Slit her wrists. Down your 5th of vodka and bottle of antidepressants.
Yeah, so am I.
Sleep well.
Why?
Can't be going to set the shop before we're done. My sister tried to get sober after the attack. She started a detox program, seeing a counselor to deal with the psychological trauma. She was really trying to get better. I suppose the whole situation was a bit of a wake-up call. Then she got the test results. The fucker that raped her was HIV positive and infected her. She was crushed. I'm sorry. Each of those vials is filled with blood. Two contain pig's blood, completely harmless. One contains the blood of an HIV positive man. You choose one vial and drink it, or I detonate the explosive in your house right now.
Please. You can't expect me to do this. You can't ask this of somebody.
My sister wasn't given an option, so why should I give one to you?
Because this is wrong. This is wrong. I'm sorry about what happened to your sister, but this is wrong. This has gone too far.
You know nothing about what is right and wrong. If you did, you would have helped my sister. You need to learn your lesson.
Corey,
you stall any longer, I make a choice for you. She would have, not knowing if she would ever be released, not knowing if she would ever live to see another day. But when that uncertainty passes, and if you find out that you chose the wrong vial, you'll feel the despair that she felt. She's getting clean, and then she gets blindsided by this, to be poisoned by her Capper C. She said she could almost feel it. You know, the last remnants of him and what he had done to her. It's too much for her to bear. No matter how hard I tried, it wasn't enough. I couldn't save her from the demons.
I'm sorry. I really mean it, Brian. I'm so sorry we failed your sister.
If I could take it back, I would, but I can't. I just can't. I know that you're a good person, a good man, and I can see how much you loved your sister. And I can only imagine the pain that you must feel over her death, but do you really want to inflict that pain onto somebody else? Is that what this will take? For me to feel the pain that you feel by taking from me those that I love? Is that what this is about?
Your wife and daughter are in no danger.
So there's no bomb?
No, there's a bomb. It's just not at your house.
Then where is it?
Downtown Newbury. It's the third lesson. To have your truths rejected and your innocence questioned at every single turn.
What are you talking about?
The police will find a second bomb in the square. That will be deemed a dud. This bomb will be marked with your fingerprints. They'll raid your home, scan your computer. They'll find incriminating emails about the bombing and online purchases of explosive ingredients, which will all be traced back to your bank account. Then they'll find a hidden letter to your wife explaining how you'd be hiding in a basement on the outskirts of the city. Keeping the aptitude of the city's police. I say you have a few hours for this to do.
No. No. They know me. They'll believe me. They'll prove that I'm innocent, and then they'll spend... They'll prove that I'm innocent, and then they'll track you down, and you'll spend the rest of your life in prison.
Well, let's hope you're right, and that you find the justice my sister was never afforded. Good luck, Corey. I've enjoyed our time together.